The Life of Yamato from Naruto. Yamato, also known as Tenzō, are both code names for this Anbu-turned-jōnin of Konohagakure, as his wood release would allow him to be able to keep the Nine Tails sealed within Naruto Uzumaki in check. He was reassigned from Anbu to the regular forces, joining Team Kakashi as a temporary replacement for their jōnin-sensei, Kakashi Hatake. While Kakashi eventually returns to the team, Yamato stays on to provide assistance as needed. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Yamato. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. The Amagi's stretch reaches beyond just this channel, so if you're a fan of us, please consider subscribing to our other channels and following us on all our social medias. Help us reach our goal of passing 100,000 followers on all of our accounts by the end of the year. And with that out of the way, let's get into the video. But first, I want to thank Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. From websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business. It can be hard to keep track of all the amazing features Squarespace offers, so let's talk about a few of our favorites. If you'd ask us what's most important in building an online venture, we'd say that it's content ownership, and Squarespace provides you with just that by letting you retain full ownership of all the content released using their service. If you'd rather work as a team, easy. Squarespace's platform offers room for several content creators to work at once. The site allows you to give selective editing roles to users through the website manager, so if you only want a user to be able to edit certain pages, you can set that in their permissions. They also allow you to easily import media into your site, whether it be traditional such as pictures and videos, or modern such as social media posts and a commenting system. We'll let you in on a little secret. Every annual Squarespace account comes with a free domain name for the first year of subscription, making it easier than ever to make your site go live. So, what are you waiting for? Go to squarespace.com/amagi and enter the promo code AMAGI to save 10% on your first purchase of a website or domain. Background. Yamato graduated from the academy at the age of 6, and at that same age was promoted to the rank of chūnin. As an infant, child in the anime, he was abducted by Orochimaru and became one of the 60 children that were his test subjects. They were injected with the first Hokage's DNA in the hopes that they could replicate the first's ability to use wood release. Before Orochimaru could finalize the results of these experiments, he was caught by Hiruzen for his other experiments and had to flee the village. Because every child who had been subjected to the experiment had died after a certain amount of time, Orochimaru believed all remaining test subjects would perish as well. In actuality, this boy was the lone survivor and found himself endowed with an unquantified wood release and likewise the first's abilities to control tailed beasts. In the anime, while contained in a test tube, he was fully conscious of his surroundings, watching in horror as other children died from failed experiments. Not wanting to die all by himself, he used his wood release to escape. He was soon afterwards found by Danzo Shimura. Having lost all memory of who he was, the boy was taken in by Danzo, where he was recruited into the Anbu's root division under the codename Kinoe. Having high hopes for Kinoe, Danzo began to personally train him as a root operative. He also gave Kinoe a scroll containing the secrets and various techniques of the wood release. As Hiruzen Sarutobi began to resume his post as Hokage after Minato Namikaze's untimely passing, Danzo sent root members, including Kinoe, to assassinate the third. However, Kakashi, a recent recruit to Root, warned the Hokage and went in his place. Kakashi quickly defeated Kinoe, but chose to spare him in the belief that he would become a valuable ally in the future. After the battle, Kinoe began following Kakashi from afar. Kinoe later informed Danzo of Orochimaru's defection from Konoha, and was instructed to meet up with Orochimaru at an underground cave that secretly housed the Iburi clan. After delivering his message to the clan, who promised to help Orochimaru escape the country, he met a young girl named Yukimi, who insisted that Kinoe was her brother, Tenzō. While Yukimi began to show Kinoe around, word soon reached them that an unknown individual had entered the cave. When the intruder, Kakashi, was subdued by the Iburi clan, Kinoe convinced them to let him interrogate Kakashi. While seemingly alone, Kinoe revealed that his actual mission was the same as Kakashi's, ensuring that Orochimaru did not escape the country. Gaara, the clan's leader, overheard this while spying and quickly ordered for both Konoha nin to be killed, though Yukimi refused to let Kinoe die, saving them both. Leaving Kakashi behind, Yukimi possessed Kinoe's body and the two traveled to a carnival where they took part in the festivities. Kakashi later caught up, planning to use Yukimi to capture Orochimaru since she was of great importance to him. Refusing to let her be used as bait, Kinoe ran off with her, announcing that his name was Tenzō. Quickly catching up to them, Kakashi explained that Yukimi's blood could temporarily bestow Orochimaru with the Iburi clan's smoke transformation, allowing him to slip across the border. Overhearing that, Yukimi slipped away and returned to the cave. Recognizing that Kinoe cared for Yukimi not unlike he had cared for Rin Nohara, Kakashi agreed to work together with Kinoe to save her. Upon returning to the cave, the two discovered that Orochimaru had killed the Iburi clan and captured Yukimi. The spirits of the Iburi guided Kinoe and Kakashi to Yukimi, causing Orochimaru to flee. Yukimi's body then began to destabilize, but the spirits of the Iburi used their power along with Kinoe's wood release to restabilize her ability. Kakashi decided to leave and not report anything about the Iburi or Root's involvement. Yukimi, no longer needing to fear the wind, parted ways with Kinoe to see the world, while the latter was happy to know that he did have the power to save people. 3 years later, Danzo, fearing that his transplanted Sharingan would eventually go blind from its overusage, assigned Kinoe and Kinoto to steal the Sharingan from Kakashi as a substitute. Kinoe found Kakashi while on a mission to investigate one of Orochimaru's abandoned labs. While initially working alongside Kakashi, he quickly attacked the other shinobi. As Kakashi tried to reason with him that friends should not kill each other, Kinoe retorted that comment, knowing that Kakashi killed his friend Rin. Enraged that Kinoe believed Kakashi killed her on purpose, he quickly overpowered him, telling Kinoe that she died because he couldn't protect her, making Kinoe remember the other test subjects he wanted to save. Refusing to kill Kinoe as he still viewed him as a friend and ally, Kakashi instead chose to take him to the third Hokage. Before he could, one of Orochimaru's snake experiments escaped its test tube and attacked the duo. As Kinoe was taken captive, Kakashi managed to slay the creature. While saving Kinoe, the creature's corpse began emitting a poisonous vapor which quickly infected Kakashi. Kinoe got Kakashi out safely, and having accepted Kakashi's words, Kinoe gave Kakashi an antidote and chose to abandon his mission, leaving Kakashi a message of it. Upon returning to Danzo, the elder was furious at Kinoe's blatant choice to defy his orders. While Kinoe insisted that Root should not target fellow Konoha members as they are allies, Danzo countered by stating that Root exists as a separate section of Konoha. Remembering the feelings of friendships from Yukimi, Kinoe ultimately decided that Root's philosophies were not for him. Disgusted at Kinoe's new view, Danzo knocked him out with his Sharingan, ordering his men to have Kinoe's cursed seal activated. As Kinoe was prepped for the operation, Kakashi arrived and freed him. The two were quickly surrounded by Danzo and several Root members. Before Danzo could act, the third Hokage appeared, vouching for Kakashi's unsanctioned arrival and convincing Danzo to give Kinoe over to him, though Danzo refused to remove the cursed seal on Kinoe's tongue. Later, Kinoe was reassigned to Team Ro under Kakashi's command. Joining his new squad, Kinoe was given a warm welcome by his allies, and Kakashi insisted that he go by his chosen name of Tenzō, which he happily agreed to. During his time in the Anbu, he served under the guidance of Kakashi and learned much from him, developing great respect for his captain. 2 years after joining Team Ro, a new Anbu was added to their team, Itachi Uchiha, who was the youngest Anbu of all time. While many of the team members questioned the wisdom of allowing someone so young to join, Tenzō and Kakashi took a great interest in the prodigy's talents. 2 years later, Tenzō was shocked to learn that Itachi was made an Anbu captain, while being even younger than Kakashi was. He and Kakashi were then approached by Yuga Uzuki, who would act as Itachi's replacement for Team Ro. Later, Team Ro was mobilized to intercept the planned coup d'etat, which was however already stopped by the slaughter of the clan. As they began gathering the corpses, Danzo told them that the culprit was their former comrade Itachi. Sometime after the genocide, Tenzō tried to comfort Kakashi, who was saddened by his inability to help or even understand his former friend. Later, after Kakashi was honorably discharged from Anbu and reassigned as a jōnin-sensei, Tenzō went to meet with his former captain, noting a positive change to Kakashi's demeanor from his new position. As Tenzō continued his career in Anbu, he would come to have the best performance record of any Anbu serving under the Third Hokage. Tenchi Bridge Reconnaissance Mission. Yamato was assigned to lead Team 7 in meeting with one of Sasori's spies within Orochimaru's ranks. Naruto and Sakura found it difficult to work with their newest team member, Sai, and much of Yamato's time was spent trying to get them to cooperate. Upon arriving at the arranged meeting place, Yamato went ahead dressed as Sasori to make the meeting with the spy easier. After the spy arrived, who turned out to be Kabuto Yakushi, Yamato was able to learn a great deal of information until Orochimaru showed up. Just as Yamato started to contemplate how he would fight Orochimaru whilst keeping up his act as Sasori, Kabuto cut the head off the Sasori costume, having hoped to kill the real Sasori. Faced with a combined attack from Kabuto and Orochimaru, Yamato created a wood clone to escape, causing Orochimaru to realize that one of his test subjects had survived. Seeing the situation he was in, Yamato signaled the rest of Team 7 to join him. A battle between Orochimaru and Naruto ensued, and Yamato spent much of his time protecting Sakura. When the battle was over, Sai was found to be missing, although a wood clone that Yamato had following Sai revealed that the latter had joined with Orochimaru. As the clone followed Sai to Orochimaru's hideout, the rest of Team 7 followed the clone. On their way, they had to break to not strain Sakura's injury, which she also lied about to Naruto, along with what happened at the bridge. Yamato secretly took Naruto aside and told him the truth. Along with telling him how dangerous it is to rely on the Nine Tails' power, he also tells him that he's strong enough without it and should use his own power to protect those he loves. Once they arrived at the hideout, Yamato used his wood release abilities to infiltrate the base. When they eventually found Sai, they restrained him and were able to learn about Sai's real mission, to join forces with Orochimaru on behalf of his organization, Root, in an attempt to destroy Konoha. Sai was eventually freed by Kabuto, who in turn was restrained by Sai. Sai, touched by Naruto's words about Sasuke Uchiha, rejoined Team 7 in their other mission of retrieving Sasuke. When the group split up again, Yamato discovered a bingo book whilst going through some of Sai's belongings. In doing so, Yamato learned that Sai once had an ulterior motive to kill Sasuke Uchiha. In desperation, Team 7 went looking for Sai, hoping to stop him from fulfilling his mission. Sai, however, had actually had a change of heart, and attempted to convince Sasuke to come back to Konoha on Naruto's behalf. Sasuke, however, ended up overpowering Sai. Due to an explosive attack from Sasuke, Team 7 was able to find Sai and learn that he had really allied with them. Upon failing to persuade Sasuke to return to Konoha, the team decided to use force instead. Sasuke's growth, however, was too much for the four's joint effort, and he was able to repel them all. After a brief confrontation between Naruto and Sasuke, Yamato attempted to capture Sasuke with his wood release, wood locking wall, although Sasuke was able to escape. As an answer to this, Yamato declared that he had no intention of getting too rough on him in front of Naruto and Sakura, but had no choice. Despite this, Sasuke prepared what appeared to be a finishing move. Orochimaru and a freed Kabuto arrived to stop him, however, and they disappeared, leaving Team 7 defeated, which made them unsuccessful in their mission. Akatsuki Suppression Mission. Kakashi recruited Yamato to help with Naruto's training in creating a new technique. In addition to being able to create training devices for Naruto with his wood release abilities, Yamato was also able to subdue Naruto if he lost control of the Nine Tails chakra. Once Naruto completed the initial stages of his training, he moved on to perfecting his pre-existing Rasengan. Kakashi, however, was not able to oversee Naruto in these final stages due to his volunteering to help Team Asuma in the fight against Akatsuki. As such, he left Yamato in charge of the technique's perfection. Yamato was able to give advice in the technique's creation and eventually bore witness to the fruits of Naruto's training. Once Naruto had perfected his technique enough to be used in battle, Yamato, Naruto, and the rest of Team 7 joined Kakashi and Team 10. After teaming up with Naruto to stop an attack by Kakazu, Yamato convinced Kakashi to allow Naruto to fight Kakazu alone. Once Naruto was successful in defeating Kakazu, Yamato joined everyone else in returning to Konoha. Three Tails Appearance. In the anime, Team Kakashi was sent to provide backup for Team 8 and Kakashi. When they located the team, Yamato assisted in rescuing Hinata. They pursued the opposing Team Guren to a lake, where they located the Three Tails. The two teams shifted objectives, and once backup from Konoha arrived, they switched objectives to seal the beast. Yamato was put in charge of a team meant to stop any attempted interference. His team was able to stop some of the enemies. However, the sealing was still disturbed and the beast was freed, creating tidal waves upon its release. He made a hideout for the teams to regroup in, and later facilitated in Naruto's rescue from the Three Tails. He also battled Kiho to stop him from interfering with the second sealing attempt, and ultimately killed him. After another failed sealing attempt, Yamato returned to Konoha with the others. Itachi Pursuit Mission. When Kakashi received permission from Tsunade to lead a special team to capture Itachi Uchiha in order to bait Sasuke, Yamato joined him as acting head of Team 8, with the pregnant Kuranai remaining behind in the village. Fated battle between brothers. While trying to locate Itachi, they're stopped by Tobi. Using the formations created for the mission, they battled the Akatsuki member. Yamato is able to seemingly immobilize Tobi with his wood technique, only for the foe to escape. Ultimately, Tobi managed to avoid every move of the group. Afterwards, Zetsu appeared and informed Tobi of the outcome of Itachi and Sasuke's battle, stating Itachi fell to him. Having distracted the Konoha nin long enough, Tobi leaves alongside Zetsu. After failing to find Itachi or Sasuke, the group was forced to abandon their mission and return to Konoha. Six Tails Unleashed. In the anime, on their way back to the village, Katsuyu appears and gives the team orders for a new mission, to help the Tsuchigumo clan protect their infamous and forbidden technique from being taken by ninja bandits. While Kakashi returns to the village for more information, Yamato is put in charge of the team. Yamato and his team unfortunately arrive at the clan's base too late, as the bandits had already broken through its defenses and forced the former clan leader's granddaughter, Hotaru, to retreat into the woods. Upon finding her, they discovered that she was traveling with a stranger named Utakada, who seemed indifferent to Hotaru's well-being, as he decided to leave her in Konoha's care. After successfully bringing Hotaru to her village, despite the mission being completed, Naruto refused to leave yet, as he felt something was wrong from how the village was so hesitant to let her return. Upon investigating, it was discovered that the bandits tracked Hotaru down and drove her back into the woods. While searching for her, they discovered Utakada had returned and was being attacked by Kirigakure Anbu Hunter Nin, who were holding Hotaru hostage. After managing to calm Naruto down, Yamato tried to talk with the Anbu, explaining the situation and asking them to release Hotaru. The Anbu initially agreed under the condition that they hand over Utakada. Yamato refused, as he knew Hotaru would refuse to go with the Konoha Nin if Utakada didn't come along. Suddenly, the Anbu's squad captain appeared to make a deal with Yamato, not wanting things to become a war between the two villages. It was then agreed that the Anbu would release Hotaru and not pursue Utakada until the Konoha Nin's mission was complete, as long as the Konoha Nin agreed not to interfere with their pursuing of Utakada afterwards. Later, the shocking truth is revealed that Hotaru has the clan's forbidden technique embedded in her back. After learning that Hotaru asked for this to help restore the clan, it is acknowledged that the technique will only cause more harm, and preparations are made to safely remove the technique from Hotaru's back and destroy it. Not wanting to give up just yet, Hotaru insists that they find a man named Shiranami, who should be able to help protect the technique, who Naruto goes off to find. Unfortunately, Hotaru runs off when Utakada suddenly leaves. Yamato has Sai track her down, back to her clan's village, which has been taken control of by Shiranami himself, who is also the bandit's leader. Yamato and the others arrive in time to hold off the possessed villagers, while Naruto and Utakada go on to save Hotaru. Pain's Assault. When the invasion began, Yamato was away on a mission with Sai and Anko Mitarashi, trying to locate and capture Kabuto. Just when they located Kabuto, Yamato was alerted to the fact that Naruto had broken the seal he had placed on the first Hokage's necklace, and was about to completely release the Nine Tails with a seal appearing in his palm with the number of tails that Naruto had manifested. He rushed back to Konoha to try and stop Naruto, but was informed by Shikaku that Naruto was able to suppress the Nine Tails' power on his own. He was later seen using his wood-release serial pillar houses technique to help rebuild Konoha, complaining that it put a lot of strain on him. 5 Kage Summit. When Naruto states that he wants to meet with the 4th Raikage, Yamato advises against it. Leaving the village is forbidden because of the Kage Summit. Yamato can no longer repress the Nine Tails because of the 1st Hokage's necklace destruction, and Yamato needs to help with the village's reconstruction. However, Naruto manages to convince Kakashi, who forces Yamato to go too. Yamato plants a wood clone seed on Team Samui, allowing him, Naruto, and Kakashi to follow them to the 4th Raikage in the Land of Iron. When Naruto is unable to sway the Raikage, even with his and Kakashi's support, the three of them rest at a local inn. Tobi confronts Naruto while there, and Yamato and Kakashi, having expected him, try and restrain him. Their attempts do not work, and after telling them the truth about the Uchiha clan and Sasuke's current motives, he leaves. Afterwards, Kakashi encourages that the three of them keep what Tobi said between them until they knew more, and if what Tobi said was true. Yamato repairs the damage he and Kakashi did to the inn. Soon afterwards, Sakura arrives with Sai and tells Naruto that she loves him, shocking Yamato. However, as the event unfolds, an angered Yamato tries to ask why she would say that, but was stopped by Kakashi before he could. As he watched and listened to Sakura talk to Naruto, he could tell she wasn't telling the truth, and like Kiba, looked upon it both questioningly and disapprovingly. She leaves when Naruto says he doesn't believe her, after which one of Sai's ink clones approaches them and tells them of Sakura's plans to kill Sasuke. Before Kakashi can go to stop her, Gaara appears and tells them about the outbreak of the 4th Shinobi World War, and Danzo Shimura's actions during the Kage Summit. Because the other Kage would prefer Kakashi were Hokage, Yamato encourages him to comply. Naruto passes out shortly afterwards, and Yamato is left in charge of looking after him while Kakashi finds Sakura. When Naruto finally awakens, he tries to go after Sakura, but Yamato stops him and insists that they return to the village. Naruto asks to rest some more, and Yamato lets him, unaware that Naruto is sneaking out, leaving a shadow clone behind so he wouldn't notice. In the anime, it is shown that after realizing that Naruto had escaped, he hunts him down on the samurai bridge and captures him, but later releases him and returns to the village on his own. Power. In the anime, Team Kakashi was assigned to investigate an attack on Tonika Village. While there, the team split into two. Yamato went with Sai. While on their search, they met some officers from a neighboring village, the Hacho Village. After hearing an explosion from a distance, Yamato, Sai, and the officers went to the location. When they arrived, their teammates were fighting Kabuto's reincarnated shinobi. Yamato soon fights a snake version clone of Hiden. He and Sai later gathered information regarding the hole. Kabuto let loose Naruto's clone, and Sai battled a reincarnated Deidara and Hiden snake clone. Yamato discussed the hole with Kakashi and other Konoha shinobi, and wondered what Kabuto could want with it. Yamato once again fought against Kabuto's reincarnated shinobi, while Naruto dealt with his clone. After Kabuto's plan was foiled, the team left the village. Fourth Shinobi World War. Countdown. In the anime, Yamato is seen in a bar with Shikamaru, telling him that since the first Hokage's necklace was destroyed, he could no longer suppress the Ninetales. Yamato is one of the Konoha ninja sent to an isolated island in the Land of Lightning as Naruto's bodyguard. When Naruto expresses an interest in finally taming the Ninetales, Yamato and Motoi accompany him to the Falls of Truth in order to defeat his dark side. After a brief encounter with the giant squid again, B instructs Naruto on how to enter his subconscious and face the Ninetales. When the Ninetales starts gaining the advantage and a chakra cloak develops around Naruto, Yamato tries to suppress it. It eventually stops on his own, surprising him. Naruto soon informs them of his victory, explaining the particulars to B through a fist bump. Being left out of the loop irritates Yamato, but he is left amazed when Naruto begins demonstrating his new control over the Ninetales and the advantages it allows him. Among the advantages is the ability to sense Kisame hidden within B's Samehada. Naruto pursues Kisame when he tries to flee, but his inexperience with his new strength and speed causes him to lodge himself in the wall. Yamato helps Naruto while B goes after Kisame. Yamato splints Naruto's sprained ankle and warns him to exercise restraint until he can gain better control over his powers. They rendezvous with B and find that Kisame has been captured. Yamato fortifies Kisame's wooden restraints while Aoba Yamashiro reads his mind. Before Aoba can learn anything of real value from the Akatsuki, Kisame breaks free and commits suicide. They try to examine the intel Kisame wanted to escape with, but it's booby-trapped, and they are trapped in water prisons while the intel makes its way to Akatsuki. Fearing that Naruto may grow suspicious about their reasons for being on the island, given his dominance over the Ninetales and the incident with Kisame, Yamato and the others convince him to take a survey of the island's native animal population to keep him busy. Akatsuki, meanwhile, launches an assault on the island, and Yamato looks after Naruto and formulates explanations for any signs of the battle that Naruto notices. When things calm down, Yamato, Aoba, and Motoi go to investigate. They come across Kabuto, and he is captured by Kurotsuchi. Yamato creates a wooden beam that Aoba can walk on to approach Kabuto and read his mind like he did before with Kisame. But Kabuto sheds his body to free himself. He goes after Yamato, and before being captured, Yamato pushes Motoi out of the way. Kabuto escapes to the mountain's graveyard, where he and Obito gather information from Yamato about the allied shinobi forces. Kabuto also studies Hashirama's DNA within Yamato to strengthen the White Zetsu army. Rather than kill Yamato when he has fulfilled his usefulness, they suspend him opposite Hashirama's clone for future use. Birth of the Ten Tails Jinchūriki. At some point during the war, his body was encased within Tobi, seemingly using Yamato's altered DNA to strengthen its own wood release. After Madara Uchiha activated his infinite Tsukiyomi, Yamato was freed from within Tobi's body in an unconscious state, as he had no further use for Tobi. He was then immediately caught in the Genjutsu. In the anime, Yamato dreamed of becoming highly respected in Konoha as the new official and permanent leader of Team 7, which included the reformed Sasuke. Kaguya Ōtsutsuki strikes. After being freed from the infinite Tsukiyomi by Naruto and Sasuke, Yamato confronted Tobi and witnessed the latter crumbling. Blank period. Following Orochimaru being pardoned for his crimes, Yamato was assigned alongside a surveillance team to keep an eye on him in case he tried to act against the five great nations. During such, he was ordered to not make direct contact with Orochimaru until such an incident occurred. Over time, Yamato became famous among his team as the only one who could directly approach Orochimaru without fear. The last, Naruto the Movie. In the novel of the film, Yamato is assigned to help protect Konoha from the moon's falling meteorites. Sakura, Hiden, thoughts of love riding upon a spring breeze. Yamato assists Konoha in the investigation regarding rumors about Sasuke joining a terrorist group that is plotting to destroy the village. Konoha Hiden, the perfect day for a wedding. Several months later, Yamato attends Naruto and Hinata's wedding. He was also seemingly following Orochimaru, making sure he doesn't do anything suspicious. When Konohamaru asked Orochimaru to record a congratulatory message for Naruto, Yamato can be seen in the background, comically signaling Konohamaru not to record Orochimaru. Sasuke Shinden, Book of Sunrise. While watching Orochimaru, Yamato encounters Sasuke, who explains Orochimaru may have information on a terrorist organization he's investigating. Cautious, Yamato asks Sasuke if he's doing this on Konoha's behalf, to which Sasuke confirms. He then lets him through and says since they're comrades, trust is important between them. Sarada Uchiha Arc. Yamato was mentioned by Kakashi during his phone discussion with Naruto, regarding the message sent by one of Sasuke's hawks. Kakashi noted that he will send Yamato to meet Sasuke and Naruto so that he could help out in the search of the mysterious boy with the Sharingan who had attempted to kill Sasuke. Later, Yamato joined up with Naruto, Sasuke, and Sasuke's daughter, Sarada Uchiha, after Sakura was kidnapped. Deciding to speak with Orochimaru since he seemingly had ties to Shin Uchiha, they went to one of his bases. Yamato decided to stay outside and wait in case anything happened. Graduation Exams Arc. As ninja classes began preparing for the graduation exams, Yamato continued his assignment of watching Orochimaru's movements. As such, he followed the Sannin on his journey back to Konohagakure to discussing matters with Naruto about his research on Danzo's old experiments. After Orochimaru delivered promising results to aid Sasuke in his own investigations, Orochimaru went off to meet with the academy instructors about Mitsuki's performance, which Yamato followed. Mitsuki's Disappearance Arc. In the anime, when learning of Mitsuki's apparent betrayal and desertion of Konohagakure, Yamato spoke with Orochimaru. While the Sannin insisted he was completely oblivious to his son's actions, Yamato suspected that Orochimaru knew something. Afterwards, Yamato spotted Mitsuki and pursued him, unaware it was actually Sarada in disguise. Yamato's team soon cornered the target and captured the genin in a barrier, but suffered interference from Karin, who then took the genin's place by disguising herself. After a long chase, Karin revealed herself before escaping in a smokescreen. Now more suspicious than ever, Yamato decided to have his team search Orochimaru's base, who had no objections. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.